Survivors of religious persecution from around the world gather in New York today to tell their stories. They spoke at the Listening to Survivors of Religious Persecution, the Call for Religious Freedom, an event hosted by the Holy See Mission to the UN and Aid to the Church in Need. Priests and nuns from Sri Lanka, Pakistan, and the Philippines spoke about their firsthand experiences of being attacked for their Christian faith. Participants also heard from witnesses who suffered different forms of violent attacks and discrimination. Our United Nations correspondent, Sabrina Ferrisi, was at the conference. She joins us now from New York with more on the issue. Sabrina, tell us a little bit more about the plight of persecuted Christians around the world. How many Christians are experiencing persecution and where?
The numbers were shocking, Wyatt. Between 250 and 300 million Christians are persecuted around the world. To put that in context, that's one in seven Christians in 143 countries. In fact, the most persecuted religion in the world today is Christianity. The worst areas are Southeast Asia, countries like India, Sri Lanka, the Philippines, Pakistan. In Africa, we see this in countries like Mali, Benin, Burkina Faso, and Nigeria. And of course, in North Korea, we have 70,000 Christians in labor camps who are there simply because they're Christians.
It is pretty scary. So why are Christians being targeted?
The number one reason is Islamist violence, and we see this in Africa, Southeast Asia, and the Middle East. But another reason are nationalist groups. For example, in India, there are Hindu nationalist groups that have carried out thousands of attacks between the years of 2017 and 2019. Last year, they burned down 100 churches in India. Another reason are state authorities. This is where there is violence on the part of the police or local government authorities against Christians, or the government won't follow up or investigate crimes against Christians.
Pretty horrific if you think your own authorities won't stand up for you. One of the issues which came up today is that the mainstream media does not report on the plight of the persecuted Christians to the same extent that it reports on other religious or ethnic groups. Why is that?
The first reason is that apparently we are numbed by statistics. We as Christians don't voice it enough, even though we are the majority religion in the United States by far. I spoke with Edward Clancy of Aid to the Church in Need, and he said that his Jewish brothers and sisters have told him, "You Christians should speak out. We would. Why don't you?" He said it's incumbent on every single Christian to raise their voice on this issue of persecution. The mainstream media, especially in this country, needs to be reminded and pushed by us.
Such an important issue, and one that we think is so vital here on EWTN. We'll continue to cover it. Sabrina Ferrisi, UN correspondent. Thanks so much, Sabrina.
Thanks, Wyatt.